Jill Edgar has asked us how to paint the eldritch symbols that you see on the back of an Ogroid Thermitage, and for this video we're going to show you how to do that. And what you should do first of all is be sure to paint all the skin of it, which I've quickly done for our example model here. I've not done all the highlights on it, which you should do beforehand, but I just want to give a good basis of what you want to be looking for before you start doing this. Now the colours you need first of all are Lotham Blue, and then we're going to shade all over this using Collier Green Shade. After that we'll add a highlight of Baharoth Blue and then a very fine highlight of White Scar. But we're going to be starting out with Lotham Blue, which I'm going to apply with a small layer brush. And what you want to do is, as always, use your palette to thin this down. You want to thin it a little bit more than normal. You're looking for about that kind of consistency there to ensure that the paint's flowing really smoothly from your brush. When you're ready, make sure you don't have loads on here, so you've got a good tip on your bristles. And what you want to do is paint this into the recess of these little symbols. So hold your hands as steadily as possible and just run the colour in the recess there like that. And you will need to apply two coats here to build up the blue to a strong finish before you go on to the next step. I finished applying the Lotham Blue, but you can see I'm just focusing on the middle of the back here just to show you what to do, because now we're ready for the next step, which is apply some Collier Green Shade into these sigils. And what you want to do is just run it into the recess like this, all the way around them. The shade's now dry and we've got some nice definition on these sigils, and what we need to do now is start building up the brighter glow. So for this we're going to start out with Baharoth Blue, still with a small airbrush, and what you want to do is paint a line of this in the middle of these sigils, leaving that shade still showing either side to keep that definition there. Really take your time with this step part and just be as neat as you can as you do it. With that done, all we need is White Scar to complete the effect, and the technique here is much the same as what we did before, only you first focus this colour on the flatter and more raised areas of muscle. So for example, that little bit of curve just there, and a small amount just here, and then as the muscle goes into that recess down there, I'll avoid that part and leave the blue stronger down there. So you just need to carry on now doing this across all these sigils. And there we are, that's the effect complete, and all you need to do is carry on doing this on all the rest of the sigils. So Jill, I really hope that helps you out, and we'll see you all again soon.